Well, the mosquito fire has been well controlled now for several weeks, and that has allowed soil scientists to go into the burn area to determine just how severe the fire was. The U.S. Forest Service recently released its soils burn severity study, and meteorologist Heather Waldman spoke with one of the scientists who was involved in this study. So what are they able to pull out of the study so far?
Yeah, well, the severity of a fire is a major factor in determining just how quickly watersheds within the burned area can return to pre-fire conditions. Water managers and other agencies care about that time frame because damage from large fires like the Mosquito Fire can significantly affect things like water quality and the risk for flash flooding and debris flows. I spoke with Eric Nasita yesterday. He's the forest soil scientist with the El Dorado National Forest. He says these kinds of surveys focus on the soil top and the life below.
So what we do is we look at soil properties and see how the heat affected it. So how much soil cover was removed, how the roots burned, how some of those things that keep the soil together burned, and we'll give that a rating.
And that rating is broken down into four categories: unburned or very low, low, moderate, and high. According to Nasita, just 9% of the 77,000 acres of the Mosquito Fire were burned at a high severity. Another 25% burned at a moderate intensity. The most intense burning occurred in the Rubicon Drainage between Forest Hill and Volcanoville. Now, compare that to last year's Caldor Fire, where 53% of the burned area was torched at a moderate or high intensity. Nasita says that as he watched the fire from his Placerville home in September, he expected very different results.
I was expecting a much worse burn severity out there. I was really surprised to see on a 77,000 acre fire how much low burn severity was out there. This was a fire where, the low soil burn severity dominated the soil burn severity, which is good to see.
Nasita says that rain that came through in mid-September no doubt played a role in limiting the fire's severity, especially on the north side. That low-intensity burn helps to clean up the forest floor without permanently damaging large trees. That overall will allow the ecosystem and the watershed to rebound faster. Based on the soil burn severity study, the Forest Service will identify infrastructure, wildlife, and trails that need treatment in the years ahead. Back to you.
Heather, thanks.